Our area's most beautiful properties deserve the finest realtors. Meeks Realty Group. We focus on buying and selling residential and commercial properties throughout the tri-state area. Contact Meeks Realty Group online at meeks.us or call 304-440-1101.
The views and opinions expressed on this program do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of 580 WCHS, its employees, or WVRC Media. From the studios of WVRC Media, the country, the United States of America, the state, West Virginia, the city, Charleston. This is the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live. And your host.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
He's kind of a big deal.
I have come here to chew bubblegum and kick ass, and I'm all out of bubblegum.
Dave Allen.
And a good Tuesday morning to you from the Parmar Store Studio. Welcome to the show. Ryan Nicholson is our producer today. Bigly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live. Brought to you by Thornhill Auto Group, including Thornhill GM Superstore. It's Chevy truck season. If you're ready for a truck that can handle any job, you need to check out the 2024 Silverado. You can get 2.9% APR for 72 months for well-qualified buyers or a $5,000 total value when you trade in an eligible vehicle. You must qualify for all offers through GM Financial. See them for all the details. Thornhill GM Superstore. Together, let's drive. Click or come by thornhillgmsuperstore.com or on the road to total savings, US 119 to Chapmanville. We do the show from the Parmar Store Studio. If there's not a Parmar Store near you now, there will be soon. Parmar invites you out for Wally and Wimpy's night this Thursday night. Buffalo Wild Wings, Cross Lanes, great food, fun, and prizes all started at 6 o'clock. Wally and Wimpy's night this Thursday night. And when you're in your local Parmar, don't forget to pick up a copy of Wally and Wimpy's, the state's premier sports publication. Again, their special night is the Buffalo Wild Wings and Cross Lanes at 6 o'clock this Thursday night. If there's not a Parmar store near you now, there will be soon. Coming up a little bit later on the show, Delegate State Democratic Party Chair Mike Pushkin is going to be joining us. Also, a couple of weeks, about a week and three or four days away from one of the biggest events in the area. It's the West Virginia Food Truck Festival at the Putnam County Fairgrounds in Eleanor. Kelli Steele, the director of the Putnam County CVB, is going to join us and talk about that. Plus, going to get into some things from Charleston City Council meeting last night. As well as always, your phone calls and texts are welcome. Again, Bigly Piggly Wiggly Hotline 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Earl Whittington is the gentleman's name. He currently serves as magistrate in Kanawha County, and he'd like to remain as a magistrate. He's joining for re-election, and he joins us now. Magistrate, good morning. Welcome to the show.
Good morning, sir. Thank you for having me.
Thank you for being here. Give us the bio on Earl Whittington.
Well, I'm 63 years of age. I was born in Columbus, Ohio. We moved here when I was 6 years old, and I've been in Kanawha County ever since. I have, I'm a 30-year veteran of the police department for the city of Dunbar. 8 of those years I spent as a police chief for the city of Dunbar, worked under 3 different mayors. I retired in 2014 from the city of Dunbar and immediately went to work for the Kanawha County Sheriff's Department, serving as a judicial security officer, protecting the judges and checking packages and so forth at the front door of the judicial building. And that's where I currently was up until the point that I was appointed as the magistrate to replace Magistrate Farrell, who left, and Chief Judge Mary Claire Akers had taken applications for that position. 17 people put in for that position, and she seen had enough faith in me to appoint me to that position, and that's what I'm currently at now, sitting in a magistrate position. I have a few hobbies. I'm a weightlifter. I like to ride motorcycles, play golf, and spend as much time on the beach as we can. I'm married to my lovely wife, Ashley, of 11 years.
Which are you better at, golfing or motorcycles?
Much better at motorcycling than I am golfing. I would have to tell you a bunch of untruthful stories of my golfing career.
And we kind of discourage that when it comes to political figures. Talk about your experience as a police officer and in that realm of things. You mentioned that you work for the Sheriff's Department. Does that give you like maybe a little advantage as far as being magistrate because you've seen things on the other side of the desk, so to speak? How does that work?
Well, I would like to think that gives me a huge advantage due to the fact that we have served on that side of the fence. Now, it's entirely two different types of jobs, but I've seen the type of people that come before the court. I've dealt with those type of people that come before the court. And I believe that my position as a police officer for 30 years, not only just as a police officer only, but also as a police administrator, a police chief, it gave me the ability and the training to make the tough decisions when we need to make the tough decisions.
Talking again with Earl Whittington, who's currently Kanawha County Magistrate, and I said you're running for re-election. You were appointed to the position, so I don't know
correct.
If that's the correct term. And what time frame was that you were appointed?
We're looking at approximately a couple months ago.
Okay, all right. So this is your first election for this, right? This is your first election.
Yes, sir, my first election. Okay. Yes, sir.
Dave Allen, Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Fresh Air. They'll change those heating and cooling unit air filters for your home, your retail or industrial business, restaurant, church, or whatever, and they can build custom filters for you. 24-hour emergency service available. Visit freshairfilters.us or call 304-440-1104 for fresh air, because everyone deserves fresh air. What do you enjoy about being a magistrate?
Well, I'm a people person. I've always been a people person. I've always wanted to help people. That's why I stayed in the position I did until retirement from law enforcement and continued on with the Sheriff's Department. It's the idea of helping people, and this just gives me another ability to possibly help people steer their life in the right direction. And they've made simple mistakes. You know, it's kind of hard to direct a career criminal in the right direction, because that's what his career is. He's going to be a criminal. But the people that, you know, sometimes good things or bad things happen to good people. And if you can help those people get off into the right direction, then you feel like you've done something. Give back to the community.
What, you know, it's a nonpartisan position, but would you like to tell us what your political party is?
Yes, sir. It is absolutely a nonpartisan, but I am a Republican.
Okay. What are some of the biggest challenges that one faces in the judicial system today, Earl?
Well, repeat offenders, obviously, is an issue that we have.
The revolving door they talk about.
Absolutely.
Seeing a lot of the same people, I should. And you saw that as a police officer, too.
Oh, absolutely. It's the same people that I was bringing to the court I'm now seeing in the court.
Or maybe their kids.
Or on the other side. Well, correct. But the challenge.
Sadly, I say that jokingly, but sadly, that is the case. A lot of law enforcement officers tell me that. And people in the judicial system in general.
The sad part is that the children end up being a product of their environment. And so, as a magistrate, you know, if we have the ability to change the environment, then mm-hmm. maybe we can help save those children.
What do you hear from the public when you've been out, you know, on the campaign trail, or just since you've been appointed to this job? If you're out at the, you know, at your local Kroger store or wherever that you happen to be pumping gas or whatever, what do people tell you that they want to see in a magistrate? What do they want to see from the court system?
Well, one, they want to see you know, dedication, and they want you to deal with the problem. There's nothing more aggravating than an individual who's had a crime committed against them, and then they see that person out, and they're re-victimized, and they see that person out again, and they're re-victimized. Sometimes you'll have the same victim on two or three different crimes, and it's very, very annoying and agitating to that person. And they're looking for a person that can hopefully stop that, and they're wanting to put their faith in a person that can maybe curtail that activity so that they're not victimized anymore. So that seems to be the biggest issue that I hear about, is that they're consistently people are being let out to commit more crimes, and we're hoping that we can change a little bit of that.
Talk about your campaign style. What have you been doing? Are you sign waving, door knocking? What are you doing?
Well, we're doing it all. I'm a people person. I get out and I talk to people. Anybody that knows me knows that that's the kind of person I am. So I will never walk into a room and leave that someone will not know me when I leave. I make it a point. I want you to feel comfortable when you talk to me. I'm approachable. I'm all about just trying to do the right thing. And that's what I tell everybody. You know, my father had taught me from a young boy, you know, that treat everyone like you want your family treated, mm-hmm. and you should be okay. Well, I did that in my career as law enforcement, and I was very successful with that.
Do you have a website or Facebook, social media, anything that you'd like to put out there to the people?
I have a campaign website.
Okay.
It's Earl Whittington Magistrate 2024. And of course, I have a personal Facebook page, but which I try to keep as fairly personal. But since in the election, it's not been too personal. Okay. Most of my friends are contacting me there, and I'm trying to send them to the campaign page.
Mm-hmm.
But that's kind of where we're at. With that part of it.
All right. Give me I do a thing or a magistrate that I call the final 30 when I ask people to give me 30 seconds uninterrupted from me. It's not actually timed. why should we actually have a stopwatch in layaway right now? We can't afford a stopwatch. Why should someone vote for Earl Whittington for magistrate?
Well, I have an extended amount of experience in law enforcement, so I know what the job entails. I'm fair. I'm firm. I'm not afraid to make the hard decisions. If you want somebody that's willing to do the right thing, that's me. Sometimes that's not always popular, but I will always do my absolute best to do the right thing. And at the end of the day, I think that's about all you can ask is do the right thing. I'm hardworking. I'm dedicated. I'm loyal. Anybody that knows me throughout my career will tell you that I am a dedicated employee. I'm dedicated to the citizens of Kanawha County. I've gave over 40 years of service to strictly Kanawha County, and I would like to continue that service with the Kanawha County citizens.
All right. Earl, we wish you the best of luck in the campaign. Earl Whittington, current Kanawha County Magistrate, hoping to be elected. You are appointed to the job and you hope to be elected this time around. I appreciate you being here. Thanks a lot.
Thank you for having me, sir.
It is 9:18, the Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Husson's Pizza. Get a large 18-inch pepperoni pizza and a large tossed salad, only $20.99 at your favorite Husson's location. Speaking of food, the West Virginia Food Truck Festival is coming to Eleanor. It's the Putnam County Fairgrounds. It's 1 week from this Saturday. Kelli Steele, who is the director of the Putnam County Convention and Visitors Bureau, they, along with the Putnam County Chamber of Commerce, will be putting this on. We're going to talk about that with Kelli when we come back right after this from the Parmar Store Studio on the Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses want to thank you for supporting local small businesses.
We need real conservatives in the House of Delegates. We need Mark Carter in District 57.
Hi, I am Mark Carter. As a conservative lawyer, I am a strong supporter of life, faith, and the Second Amendment.
Mark Carter was appointed to national offices by both President Donald Trump and President George W. Bush. Let's elect a new conservative Republican to the House.
I am Mark Carter, and I would appreciate your vote for House of Delegates.
Paid for by Mark Carter for West Virginia.
Hey, it's Sydney, and it's time to find new roads to savings during Chevy truck season. Ready for the truck that can handle any job? You need the new 2024 Chevy Silverado from Thornhill GM Superstore on the Thornhill Motor Mile. Best-in-class power, durability, and technology. Thornhill has customized Silverado to fit your needs. During Chevy truck season, enjoy 2.9% APR for 72 months for well-qualified buyers or $5,000 total value when you trade in an eligible vehicle. Thornhill GM Superstore, together let's drive. Click or come by at thornhillgmsuperstore.com or on the road to total savings, US 119 Chapmanville. Must qualify for all offers through GM Financial. Visit Thornhill for all details.
Hi, I'm David McCormick, owner of Omega Commercial Interiors. We'd like to thank you, West Virginia, for making us the number one office furniture and commercial interiors company in West Virginia. Remember, when you're looking for quality office furniture and space planning for healthcare, corporate offices, or even a private office, call us and buy local. Omega Commercial Interiors. We're a proud West Virginia company. Visit us online at OmegaCommercialInteriors.com in Morgantown and Charleston.
It is 9:20, the Dave Allen Show and 580 Live, brought to you by your hometown baseball team, the Charleston Dirty Birds. Dirty Birds will have a home run derby at the ballpark, Gomar Ballpark, this Saturday. Gates open at 5:30. The home run derby starts at 6:30. Members of the Dirty Birds team will be matched with local community members. Details coming up a little bit later on the week. Matter of fact, I will have folks from the Dirty Birds on the show on Friday to talk about it. And I do understand that we are going to have people from this here media company here that are going to take part in that. Don't know exactly who. I need to get with Coop and find out who is going to take part in that. I do know that one of the parts of the celebrity wing, if you will, as he said on the show yesterday, is going to be Kanawha County Commissioner Ben Salango. He is actually going to be one of the people taking part, and hopefully, because Salango told the story on the air yesterday, that as a young basketball player, how he scored the winning basket for the other team. We're hoping that he doesn't embarrass himself again, but that's coming up at the ballpark, and again, we'll have more details coming up on Friday's show. Tickets are on sale now. DirtyBirdsBaseball.com. Kids 12 and under get in for free. Had a text here, and I just had Earl Whittington on the show, and it was a text that says, does Magistrate Whittington collect police retirement and magistrate pay? If so, is it considered double dipping? I asked him about that off the air, and he does collect a retirement, but it is perfectly legal. It's gone through all the process, and he's allowed to do that, according to a texter. Texter says, I like this guy. He appears to have common sense. Well, there you go. Which means he won't get very far in politics. I'm kidding. But Dave Allen Show and 580 Live is brought to you part by Bridge Valley. Are you interested in improving your company's IT workforce? Well, did you know Bridge Valley offers custom-tailored IT training to bridge the skills gap? At Bridge Valley, you can train for little or no cost with a 50-50 salary match. Bridge Valley can also supply skilled graduates and apprenticeships for your company. Visit bridgevalley.edu/apprenticeships today for more information. Coming up a little bit later on the show, State Democratic Party Chair and Delegate Mike Pushkin is going to be here. Plus, we're going to address some things from Charleston City Council from last night as well. Let's talk about some fun stuff. Right now, the West Virginia Food Truck Festival is happening in the city of Eleanor at the Putnam County Fairgrounds, and it's 1 week from this Saturday. I'm going to be there because, well, it's food. Admission is free, lots of great food, games, and, of course, great music, too. Kelli Steele, the executive director of the Putnam County Convention and Visitors Bureau, they are presenting this along with the Putnam County Chamber of Commerce. Kelli joins us now. Good morning. Welcome to the show.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
I was thinking about this, Kelli. How long has this been going on? Because I can remember when it started in downtown Hurricane, but in effect, really got, with all due respect to the folks in Hurricane, they were wonderful. It actually got a little bit too big for downtown Hurricane, and they had to move it over to the fairgrounds. How long has this been going on?
The first festival was in 2016, but this is the sixth festival because of breaks due to COVID and remodeling of the Valley Park. So this is our sixth festival, but the, you know, it started in 2016. You're right, in Hurricane. It was originally in Valley Park and then downtown, and we just ran out of space.
I forgot about it being in Valley. It was in Valley Park. I forgot about that, too. I was only thinking about the one in downtown Hurricane. But it is a great event. It always is. What are the hours? And again, it's all going to be 1 week from Saturday on the 27th. What are the hours over there?
So you can come in for free from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. Anytime. No ticket required. And this year we've added on a VIP ticket option from noon to one. So that's only $10, and that gets you in an hour early and gets you, like, you know, shorter lines. We limit the number of tickets. So you can come in, you know, when you're really hungry for lunch and enjoy the trucks and enjoy some craft beer and the live music with low crowds, or you can come in for free starting at 1 p.m.
All right, either one. Again, we're talking with Kelli Steele from the Putnam County Convention and Visitors Bureau about the West Virginia Food Truck Festival. And that's what, you know, if there's been any complaints, Kelli, and people like to complain, and that's okay, because when you start messing with their food, they do get a little touchy sometimes.
I get cranky too.
I get hangry, as they say. Uh-huh. The lines in the past for the food trucks have been quite long. So you're hoping, and you, the organizers are hoping, that this is going to kind of help to alleviate that situation?
That's right. So it gives people an opportunity to make sure that they're not waiting in line for an extra long time, and to try some multiple trucks before the lines get crowded. And the other thing we recommend, if you really, you know, you don't want to pay the extra money, which we'd love for you to pay the extra money. It helps us bring in great entertainment, which I'm sure you'll mention, but, it does. We do see that the crowds tend to drop off the longer the festival goes on. The risk there is that, you know, some of your favorite dishes might be sold out by then, but there are, you know, the crowds are thinner starting at around 3-4 o'clock.
Yeah.
So that's the other option.
Let's talk about the music. Who do we have on the musical lineup this year?
Yeah, we have Keegan McLean is playing during that VIP hour from noon to one. And then after that, we have the River Jam Band. We have Spurgy Hankins and Evie Schaefer. So that rounds it out. They're playing each for about an hour. So you can come and enjoy live music for the whole day. Great acts coming up, too.
The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you part by General Hardware of Winfield and Milton and General Lumber of Winfield. If you're planning a project this spring, please shop locally. They're also hiring. Stop by any location for details. Visit generalhardwarewv.com. Let's talk about the charitable aspect of this, Kelli.
Yeah, so each year we choose a different nonprofit partner, and any profits that are received from the festival, along with proceeds from a raffle basket and donations, go to a different local nonprofit each year. And this year is the Friends of the Putnam Library. So it helps support our local library system. They do a ton of great programming all year round, plus summer reading, you know, for the little ones in the summer. But we just have a very active an engaged library system and want to do what we can to support the work that they're doing here.
And again, the food is the highlight over there, but we mentioned the music, and also there is craft beer available if people want that. And a lot of games have been done in the past, too.
That's right. We always have some lawn games, so you can come and play cornhole or lawn Jenga. Connect Four, we have plenty of things set out. We'll have Frisbees again this year so people can toss a Frisbee around. And we do encourage folks, while we do have picnic tables and things set up, we do encourage you to bring your camp chair, your lawn chair, or just a blanket to spread out. When it's crowded, it's hard to find a seat, and that way you can just kind of find your favorite spot and enjoy the music for several hours.
What about pets? Somebody texted the show, I remember, once before and asked about bringing your pets over there. I mean, you're in a big old wide open field as long as they're not out of control. Same with your kids, by the way. They both need to be on leashes.
We don't require a leash for kids, but, you know, that's up to you. We do ask that you, if you're going to bring your dog or your cat, you know, put them on a leash or a harness. But pets are welcome. We love greeting our furry friends over there.
Are we at the point where we can mention some of the food trucks that are going to be there?
Yeah, we have some of them up on the website now, and I'll be working with the chamber to get more. I do know that we have 15 registered, and the ones that are ready to show up are Wild Wonderful Barbecue, the Rolling Stoves, which I'm excited. That's a new truck for us. Farmhouse Fixins, they were there last year. Crafts of the Coal Ice Cream, Wicked Cool Shaved Ice and Lemonade. We also have some donuts, some tacos, and we'll be updating that. You can find all of the details on wvfoodtruckfestival.com. But we have about 15 trucks signed up so far, and we are still accepting. If it's the last minute and you want to come, you can sign up on the website.
And what is the deadline for people to sign up if they want to take part?
Yeah, that would be this Friday.
So we need about a week.
Yeah. Notice to get you in there.
Yeah, and make sure that people know that. And again, it's a wonderful facility to have this in, Kelli. And again, the folks at Valley Park were wonderful, and downtown Hurricane were wonderful as well. But the decision was made a couple of years ago to move it over there because you're in that big, wide open fairground type space over there. You got plenty of free parking, and it's certainly not a long drive. It's a short drive right off the main drag there, off Roosevelt and Eleanor. You can find it easily, and this thing just gets bigger and better every year, with people literally coming from all over this part of the country for this thing.
That's right. We're excited about it and looking forward to it, and we're very thankful to have the fairgrounds available to us to host the event. It gives us plenty of space, lots of power. Food trucks take a lot of electricity,
and so
it's great for the trucks and great for attendees. We've got plenty of room for you to stretch out and enjoy the spring day.
Hopefully the weather will be great, because you know, this time of year you never know what it's going to be. We've done it over there because I've served as your MC, and in the past we've had it it was so hot you couldn't stand it, to where we were all wearing jackets.
you never know.
Welcome to spring in West Virginia. All right, the event is Saturday the 27th, starts at noon at the Putnam County Fairgrounds in Eleanor, the 2024 edition of the West Virginia Food Truck Festival, and again proceeds will benefit the library system in Putnam County. Give us the website. I know you're all over social media, but give us the website again. And if you have a food truck and you want to sign up, you got to do it by this Friday. And I'm going to have you on the day before the Food Truck Festival, which will be 1 week from this Friday. So that way you can give us an updated list of the food trucks that are going to be there. But give us the website again, Kelli.
Yeah, it's wvfoodtruckfestival.com.
All right. It's the 27th of April, 1 week from this Saturday, over in Eleanor at the Putnam County Fairgrounds, the 2024 edition of the West Virginia Food Truck Festival. Kelli Steele from the Putnam County Convention and Visitors Bureau. I appreciate you being here. Thanks a lot.
Thanks for having me.
All right. And again, the CVB sponsors that in conjunction with the Putnam County Chamber of Commerce. And if you've never had an opportunity, check it out. You need to make sure you do so, because it is a big, big old event. It's just a big party, 5 or 6 hours over there. Hopefully the weather is good. You can bring your pets out if you want. You can enjoy some craft beer, or you can just have some food. But the lines can be a little bit long. That's why they're doing the whole VIP thing. Just go to the website, go to their Facebook page, and get more information about it there. We hope to see you there over in Putnam County 1 week from this Saturday. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. Special Olympics embodies the true spirit of sportsmanship. It's not merely about winning medals. It's about being part of a team, practicing, and competing together. The joy and fulfillment derived from these experiences are immeasurable as athletes find their confidence and self-worth through the shared pursuit of victory. West Virginia Enriched, in collaboration with Huntington, invites you to witness the transformative power of Special Olympics. See a video highlighting the Special Olympics at facebook.com/580WCHS. As you know, the cleanup is continuing following the storms of last week. Now, tomorrow night, there's going to be a chance for those who were impacted to make official their storm damage reports. 7 o'clock tomorrow evening at the Washington District Community Center. The address is 1313 Sand Plant Road, South Charleston, and the space is being provided courtesy of the City of South Charleston. This is an opportunity for residents to get in-person help in completing the storm damage reports and to be able to talk to people face-to-face with the necessary officials and representatives. Again, tomorrow night, 7 o'clock, 1313 Sand Plant Road. Delegate J.B. Akers is one of those taking part, and he is going to join us on the show tomorrow to talk about it. But if you are one of those people impacted, it's an opportunity to get help in filling out the damage reports and to just talk to officials one-on-one. Again, it's happening tomorrow night, 7 o'clock. It's 1313 Sand Plant Road is where it's happening. It's at the Washington District Community Center. And again, Delegate J.B. Akers, appreciate the information there. He and others will be on hand. Delegate Akers will be on the show coming up tomorrow to talk about it. Phone calls to the Dave Allen Show, a service of Biggly Piggly Wiggly. When shopping at your Biggly Piggly Wiggly, be sure to join their loyalty program. You can save big at the gas pumps and throughout the store with their electronic coupons and free gifts on Fridays just for stopping by. From farm to table, Biggly Piggly Wiggly, the best kept secret in Charleston. Texting services provided by Fruith Pharmacy, your hometown family pharmacy. Find the perfect over-the-counter hearing aid at Fruith with Nuvamed hearing aids, plus Fruith makes it easier to transfer your prescription services to them. Fruith is your hometown family pharmacy. I did not get to attend the Charleston City Council meeting last night, nor did I get to watch online, as I frequently do. I was actually attending the wake of a very good friend of mine from my hometown, so I was kind of out of the pocket last night. I do understand, though, from talking to people that were there, that there were people, including one of the accusers of former police chief Tyke Hunt, that were upset that more isn't being said about the investigation into the former police chief. He, of course, was placed on administrative leave. He's been knocked down a couple of ranks as far as his title goes. And we all know the story now. It's been all over the news, covered on this show and other places. Councilwoman Shannon Snodgrass spoke at last night's council meeting asking why more has not been released. The city, the mayor, the new police chief, Scott Dempsey, all saying that it is a personnel issue. And I, like others, have asked for details. You know, there was more information that came out last week. Had the mayor on the show on, what was it, Friday, I guess. Thursday is when we had the severe storms and the flooding in Kanawha County. I had the mayor on at that time, and I had people then telling me I should have asked her. Well, that's not the time and place to ask that sort of question. If they do want to release any information about that, again, the chief and the city are saying it's all a personnel issue. They're more than welcome to come on this show. I will make time available. I make time for everybody on this show. I do understand, in talking to Hoppy Kercheval, that he is going to discuss it some on Talkline next hour. Former Mayor Charleston Danny Jones is going to be on the top of the show, I understand, with Hoppy, to give his take on the whole thing. And there may or may not be one of the members of City Council on the show. I talked to Hoppy about that a little bit this morning. I don't know what the final verdict on that was, whether Shannon Snodgrass was going to be on the show or not. But Councilwoman Snodgrass, the mayor, everybody, they're always welcome on this show. All they got to do is just let me know. But again, Hoppy is going to get into that coming up a little bit, I think top of the hour, with former Mayor Danny Jones on Talkline. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Fruith Pharmacy text 304-935-5008. The Dave Allen Show on 580 Live, brought to you in part by Morgan & Morgan. If you're injured, hire Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. We're going to take a break. When we come back, State Democratic Party Chair and Delegate Mike Pushkin is here. Back after this from the Parmar Store Studio on The Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Are you looking for a technical job in the medical field? Generations is growing and looking to add on job-trained physical therapy techs to our rehab team. To apply, visit one of our 7 convenient locations or simply click on us at generationspt.com.
Thrive with 5 at the best community bank in the Kanawha Valley, Poca Valley Bank. Boca Valley Bank is now offering a certificate of deposit special, 10-month APY, annual percentage yield 5%. Take advantage of this great rate to grow your savings. For more information, stop by a Boca Valley Bank location today or call 844-782-2651. Boca Valley Bank, where relationships matter. Certain terms and conditions apply. Rates based on minimum annual percentage yield, subject to change without notice. Minimum deposit required of $10,000 of new money not currently on deposit with Boca Valley Bank to receive APY. Member FDIC.
Our children and families deserve leaders on the Kanawha County Board of Education. And Kate White is a leader that our families can trust. Kate White fights for safer schools for our kids and the best education for our children and teachers in Kanawha County. Kate White is a wife, a mother, and a leader in our community. Kate White understands our families and will deliver a world-class education for all of us. Let's vote for better education and a brighter future in Kanawha County. Let's vote for Kate White for Kanawha County Board of Education. Paid for by the committee to elect Kate White for school board.
Dwayne Duncan is a Republican running for Kanawha County Commission. We know that we can trust Republican Dwayne Duncan to deliver for Kanawha County families. Dwayne Duncan wants lower taxes, more jobs, and will fight the crime problem in Kanawha County. Dwayne Duncan is a Republican and proven job creator. Taxes are too high for Kanawha County. Let's vote to keep more of our hard-earned money. Let's vote for Republican Dwayne Duncan for Kanawha County Commission. Paid for by Dwayne Duncan for Kanawha County Commission. Tori Takubo, Treasurer.
Hey there, Charleston wrestling fans. It's Hollywood Jeff Petty here, and I've got something big for you. Join my friends and myself every Monday at 1 p.m. on Charleston Sports Radio 106.7 and 1490 WSWW for The Grill Out. We're talking everything professional wrestling. We'll be serving up the hottest takes, juiciest debates, and the most electrifying moments from the world of professional wrestling. Can you smell what The Grill Out is cooking? Sure you can. Mondays at 1 p.m. on 1490 WSWW.
Minutes away from 10, the Dave Allen Show, 580 Live, presented in part by Pinnacle Consultants. Whether you're replacing your roof, remodeling the kitchen, or replacing a bathroom, keep it safe, keep it legal. Get with Pinnacle Consultants. They can inspect your site, collect samples, perform lab analysis, and provide results within about a week. Testing all renovations for mold, asbestos, and lead is the law in West Virginia. Visit PinnacleCorp.net for Pinnacle Consultants, because what you don't know can hurt you. Ryan Nicholson is our producer today. Biggly Piggly Wiggly Hotline, 304-345-5858. Fruit Pharmacy text, 304-935-5008. Coming up, I mentioned former Mayor Danny Jones on Hoppy at 10:06. Brad McElhenney is going to be on. More on the Trump trial with Tanya J. Powers of Fox News Radio. Jared Halpern from Fox News Radio also on the show. Hoppy Kirchville, 10:06 from the Incova Insurance Studios in the Dale Miller Building in Morgantown. Coming up right here. All right, Mike Pushkin. Hey, man, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you doing? Thanks for having me on.
Doing well. Thanks for coming in. You're Natalie Clad, all dressed up today, man.
Is it Natalie Clad?
Natalie Clad.
Like, who's Natalie Clad? Yeah.
Not to be confused with former Secretary of State Natalie Tennant, who is going to be on this show.
Who's also very well dressed.
Is going to be on the show this Friday.
Yeah. Well, I guess you're going to have cameras installed here soon. So this will be the norm at some point.
For one of you. No, my days in state government are done, man. I'm not wearing suits and ties anymore. But yeah, we are going to have cameras. We got ladders over in the corner. In case you get, out on a rail here and I decide I want to go hang myself, I've already got a ladder over there. So
it's not worth it, Dave.
Don't do it. So, all right. We got interims going on before we get into what you're really here to talk about. How have interims gone? We'll get specific, but overall.
That fits right into what I'm on here to talk about. Because I think the most interesting meeting so far, a meeting that went almost an hour over schedule. We were scheduled to have a meeting, the Joint Committee on Health was scheduled to meet from 4 to 6 yesterday, and we went well past 6. Almost to 7, and because of the importance of the issue, and that was the funding for the IDD waiver program, which is the waiver to help folks and their families with intellectual and developmental disabilities. It's an issue that's been talked about, and as it should be. It's incredibly important that this program is funded. And I'll get political. I'm very partisan. I'm the chair of the West Virginia Democratic Party. This is not an issue to politicize. This is life or death to the families and the members of the IDD waiver program. It's incredibly serious. And it was the program was cut in the current budget that passed. I didn't vote for it. A lot of folks didn't vote for it. In that budget that passed in the, on the 11th hour of the session, there were drastic cuts to Medicaid in general, just draconian cuts to Medicaid, but mainly to this IDD waiver program that allows for folks to get care in their homes or in a smaller setting, keeps these people out of institutions where they do not belong. And it's incredibly important, and it's definitely not something to play politics with. So I think the money needs to be, at the very least, restored. I mean, the House budget actually added $11 million to the program. But after this hearing we had yesterday, I think that they could, they being the Department of Human Services, if the money is restored, that they could and they should, and we need to hold them accountable to it. They need to increase the Medicaid reimbursement rate for the providers of these services so they are able to pay people better to work as direct care workers. There's a crisis level shortage of direct care workers in this field. We can't find enough people to do this very important and very difficult job of caring for these folks who need this help. So like I said, it's time to leave politics at the door and just fix this.
Does it come down to pay? Is that why we can't get people to fill these positions, Mike?
I mean, that's basic, you know, capitalism 101, isn't it? I mean,
people like to eat.
If you have a shortage, if you have a shortage of folks in a certain area, yeah, and then generally the pay needs to be better. It's an incredibly difficult job. If you can make more money working fast food or working at Walmart and you can leave your job at work, you're going to do that as opposed to working in a field where it's incredibly difficult. You're working with clientele that sometimes is difficult to work with,
sure,
but very, you know, very important to work with them, and they need our help. Also, when there's a shortage in the workforce, you might not get off work at the time you're supposed to get off work. If nobody shows, if there's nobody there to relieve you, mm-hmm, you cannot just leave that client there.
And you've got friends and, or you got family and you got other responsibilities you got to take care of.
Yeah, so it's an incredibly difficult job. They need to be paid what they deserve, and I think that's how we're going to attract more people into that field. We're unable to do that right now. The providers can't do that. The agencies that hire these direct care workers, they're unable to do that right now because the Medicaid reimbursement rates are too low, much lower than any other state. They're very low, and so we need to at least raise it to be, you know, competitive with surrounding states. And in order to do that, yes, we need to, the legislature needs to do its job. We need to restore the money to that, you know, to that line item for these waiver
programs.
Did you
hear the interview I did with Senate Finance Chair Eric Tarr yesterday?
I did.
Okay. And your response?
I disagree with much of what he said.
Was this brought out in the meeting that was held yesterday? Because were both of you on that in the same committee?
Well, what he was saying is, well, that we don't need to, we should cut them because they're not spending all the money they're getting. Well, they're not spending, they being the Department of Human Services, aren't spending down the money because there's not enough services to spend it on. Okay, so if somebody's a member of the IDD program, say if you have a child that needs this extra help and they're saying, well, they could benefit from this service, from that service, well, they're going to be appropriated a certain amount of money. But if there's nowhere to spend it, if those services don't exist, well, then that money goes back to the department, or the money doesn't go out to the client to begin with. So they appropriate more money than what could be spent because, unfortunately, there's not enough services out there for them to spend it on. Okay, so we need to be able to increase that. We need to allow them. And first of all, let's be clear. The legislature does not have the ability to increase the reimbursement rates. The department does. They need to do that, but we need to make sure that they are able to do that by giving them that, making sure they have the money in that line item so they are able to confidently raise the reimbursement rates. And then we need to hold the providers accountable. If they get that increase in the reimbursement rates, they have to make sure that passes down to the direct care workers. I believe it will because there's such a shortage in that field. They're going to have to increase their pay to draw people to that field.
Talking to State Democratic Party Chair and Delegate Mike Pushkin. So let's talk about the meeting that was held yesterday, the committee meeting. You were in on that. Others were. What came out of the meeting? I mean, basically what you're saying now?
I thought it was a very productive meeting. Like I said, it went almost an hour over what was scheduled, and nobody got up and left because it's that important. Right? Like I said, this isn't political. This is life or death.
Do you feel it's being politicized, though, Mike?
I hope it doesn't.
Okay.
I think we need to keep that out of it. I don't think we need to be playing, any kind of political football with the lives of people who are disabled, who have intellectual and developmental disabilities. That shouldn't be political.
There was quite a turnout at the Capitol, and we had a story posted about, I know Kerry covered the story on Sunday at the Capitol, a rally held, and I don't know if there were people there yesterday or not, but there was quite a turnout.
There
of
was
people
a huge
that,
turnout
that agreed
on
with
Sunday.
What you're saying at the Capitol.
Yeah, well, it was the families of people who were in the program, a lot of the clients. There were some it was the most moving thing. I mean, if you're not moved by that, when somebody gets in or up there and speaks and they advocate for themselves, somebody who has a developmental disability gets up, takes the microphone and talks about why this program is important. This one gentleman said, if he doesn't have this help, he is going to be left alone, sitting in his own filth. It's if you're not moved by that, I'm not sure if you have a heart. So this is something where you leave politics at the door, you restore their funding, you've got to hold the department accountable, make sure that they do keep their end of the bargain and give a significant rate increase, and that the providers pass that rate increase along to the direct care workers, so we have people who are able to go into the homes and take care of people's loved ones.
Tech says, wife said week 3 of back in the office at DHHR, she laughed last night at dinner telling me about the office drama and the threat of grievances. I don't know if this has to do with the remote worker thing.
I think that has more to do with this executive order that came. Well, it wasn't an executive order. This memo that went out among mm-hmm. about taking away the ability for remote and hybrid work. I've said before, I think a lot of these folks were hired with that expectation that they would be able to at least partially work from home. You can't pull the rug out from under them. If that's how they were hired on and they were pulled away from the private sector with this offer of job flexibility, and if they're getting the job done, then what does it matter where they do it from? So, and a lot of these places, they've been doing this hybrid work for so long that they don't even have the office space to accommodate them if they come back. So mm-hmm. it's going to be a big problem, and especially in the folks who run the IDD program. Heard from them. A lot of them have been working remotely and are now being called back in. We already have a shortage in the public sector. I don't think this is going to help the matter. It's going to hurt it, but I agree.
Let's talk about, before we go to break, there will be a session held next month. You got your not interims, but your special session coming up next month. What would you like to see on the call, Mike?
Well, first of all, we need to fix the budget, which is what I'm talking about right mm-hmm, now. Right. We need to restore that money, especially in Medicaid. And, in that Medicaid line item specifically, we need to restore the money to the IDD waiver program. That's of utmost importance, especially to the people who live it every day, people who rely on that money. But I also agree with Mayor Williams, the Democratic candidate for governor, that we should put a constitutional amendment to allow people to decide for themselves on reproductive freedom. Every other state has taken it up, and even President Trump said this should be up for the states. Well, let's leave it up to the people of the state.
And so you'd like to see that on the call?
Yes, I would.
Do you think it's going to happen?
No, I don't. I think they're afraid. I think they're afraid that they would lose that just like every other state.
So I don't think I will say this, and then we'll go to break. I don't think that – I think the Republican Party had better be careful what they wish for. They don't want it for a reason, because as you said, Mike, and this is not me being this is not my personal opinion. Look at where – when similar issues or similar candidates have been on the ballot in other states – the extreme pro-life movement loses, and it loses
every single time.
And it loses big
since the Dobbs decision. Since Roe has been overturned, every single time that people get to speak, they speak very loudly and clearly. That's a right.
That's a right that has been
women have had in this country for 50 years, and it was taken away from them. So I think let the people speak on this. They will say, well, they voted in 2018. 2018, it was a hypothetical. Roe hadn't been overturned yet. Also on the ballot in 2018 was public funding. This has nothing to do with public funding. It's simply a return to Roe is what we're asking for. The same constitutional amendment that they voted on in Ohio. That's what we've asked for. Now, also what I think should be on the budget, that constitutional amendment, of course, that's part of the budget. But, having the governor keep his promise about the funding to West Virginia State University, I think that's also very important for this valley as well.
Text says, Mike, are pregnant women able to claim their in-womb child as a dependent?
I don't believe so. I'm not a tax expert, but no, I just think that women should, I think we should let women make decisions for themselves and have the government stay out of it.
But Dave, but
I can't answer tax questions. call H&R Block on that. They have some free time. Tax day was yesterday.
But Dave Allen Show on 580 Live is brought to you part by Live Healthy West Virginia, presented by WVU Medicine. Live Healthy tackles pressing health issues. It's a podcast offering insights into medical breakthroughs and preventative care, featuring WVU Medicine's expert physicians aimed at fostering healthier lifestyles in and beyond the state. It's a valuable resource for all. Discover the latest episodes on WVMetroNews.com. Under the podcast menu, start your journey towards better health today. Back after this on The Voice of Charleston, WCHS.
Brought to you by the Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses. Eric J. Tarr Family Businesses care for your family.
We need real conservatives in the House of Delegates. We need Mark Carter in District 57.
Hi, I am Mark Carter. As a conservative lawyer, I am a strong supporter of life, faith, and the Second Amendment.
Mark Carter was appointed to national offices by both President Donald Trump and President George W. Bush. Let's elect a new conservative Republican to the House.
I am Mark Carter, and I would appreciate your vote for House of Delegates.
Paid for by Mark Carter for West Virginia.
Hey, it's Sydney, and it's time to find new roads to savings during Chevy truck season. Ready for the truck that can handle any job? You need the new 2024 Chevy Silverado from Thornhill GM Superstore on the Thornhill Motor Mile. Best-in-class power, durability, and technology. Thornhill has customized Silverado to fit your needs. During Chevy truck season, enjoy 2.9% APR for 72 months for well-qualified buyers or $5,000 total value when you trade in an eligible vehicle. Thornhill GM Superstore, together let's drive. Click or come by at thornhillgmsuperstore.com or on the road to total savings, US 119 Chapmanville. Must qualify for all offers through GM Financial. Visit Thornhill for all details.
Hi, I'm David McCormick, owner of Omega Commercial Interiors. We'd like to thank you, West Virginia, for making us the number one office furniture and commercial interiors company in West Virginia. Remember, when you're looking for quality office furniture and space planning for healthcare, corporate offices, or even a private office, call us and buy local. Omega Commercial Interiors. We're a proud West Virginia company. Visit us online at OmegaCommercialInteriors.com in Morgantown and Charleston.
If you haven't already, make sure you download the all-new Metro News TV app. Enjoy your favorite Metro News programs, Talk Line, Sports Line, Three Guys, and more. The Metro News TV app for your Apple TV, iOS, Android, Roku, Amazon, and more. Mike Pushkin is here. Text says, seems silly that Pushkin wants only the people to vote on abortion. If we do that, why do we need delegates? Aren't we a representative democracy?
I think on a question this important, we should do what every other state has done with the issue and put it up to the people. So, yeah, I think the people should have a right to decide on this. And if the Republicans are so sure that they have public support on this, well, then they shouldn't be afraid. They should allow us to vote on it.
Text says, the people already decided, the people put in our Constitution, but there is no right to abortion in West Virginia, and I'm against abortion because it's wrong to intentionally kill a human being.
It was a hypothetical back then because Roe had not yet been overturned. And what the people who say that forget about is that also had public funding in it. I think there are people out there who are pro-choice yet fiscally conservative. I know a lot of people like that that might be pro-choice, but they're not for public funding of it. Completely different question, completely different issue, and it's completely different time now that Roe has been overturned.
Text says, does Pushkin get a salary or some other compensation as chairman of the company versus Democratic Party? If so, how much is it?
No.
You don't have to discuss your...
I can discuss it. No, the chair of the Democratic Party in West Virginia, it is not a paid position. It's a volunteer position.
All right.
A full-time job and no pay.
Text says, Republicans are scared to death of direct democracy. They may chant we the people, but they mean we the Republicans will tell you what to do and will control your lives. Just look at the failed West Virginia constitutional amendments from the last election. Everyone was a power grab by the Republican legislature.
Yeah, and they put a constitutional amendment on this time about physician-assisted suicide in West Virginia, which is already illegal. We don't have that in West Virginia. So they put that meaningless constitutional amendment on the ballot. And now there's a chance that they're going to put another constitutional amendment on the ballot, one that failed at the last hour in the legislature about saying that only U.S. citizens can vote. Well, guess what? In every state of the union, only U.S. citizens can vote. It's another just political ploy. So if we're going to have those types of meaningless constitutional amendments, how about one that is meaningful to many folks in West Virginia, and that's restoring their reproductive freedom?
Text says, please talk to Mike Pushkin about Stewartgate and his threatening to weaponize the West Virginia AG's office. Reference to State Senator Mike Stewart, who's running for Attorney General. He'll be facing J.B. McCuskey as one of the opponents in the Republican primary. Mr. Stewart, you know the situation right now. You know the thing in Mingo County. We talked about it on the show. He basically said in a tweet that he has exposed corruption and that Mingo County would be a good place to start on that.
The corruption is them not endorsing him. Is that corruption or is that just their choice?
Well,
because, and I said it, you know, when I started this interview, that not there's certain things you don't politicize. The IDD waiver program is something we shouldn't politicize. Helping people with disabilities is something we should definitely not politicize. Another thing you shouldn't politicize is, you know, a state trooper and their family who was killed in the line of duty. And I think they felt that he made this overly political, especially when, you know, the widow of this state trooper has asked him to stop politicizing her husband's death, and he ignored her pleas and kept going on. Now, I don't think it has anything to do with the Mingo County Deputy Sheriff's Association. It has everything to do with Mike Stewart and his, you know, inability to separate politics from just being a decent human being sometimes.
Tex says, I'm tired of hearing the pro-abortionist's so-called concern over the health and safety of the person they call a mother. If that clump of cells she's carrying around is not a human baby, then how do you refer to her as a mother? If the cells are not a baby, then she is not a pregnant mother.
Let the people vote. That's all I'm saying. You can vote no, you can vote yes, but I want you to be able to vote.
Texas PSA mainly to Pushkin, we're West Virginia, not every other state that didn't support the representative democracy.
What's that?
I think it's a little history lesson saying that West Virginia did not represent the West Virginia didn't go along with the representative democracy. I have to look that one up. IRS website says, the texter says, child is to be born alive to get tax dependent status. Mike, if the Republicans are going to use the government to force births, the least the remaining Democrats can do is make state code to include the fetus as a dependent, since a fetus would be considered a child by law.
That's an interesting concept. I just think the people should be able to vote on it. And really what the main thing I came on here to talk about, yes. I want to get back to
it. All right, close it with that.
It's so important that we restore the money to the waiver programs. And there's more than just the IDD waiver, which is the waiver for folks with intellectual and developmental disabilities. There's also the age of disabled waiver. There's also the traumatic brain injury waiver. There's also, as a separate line item now, the substance use disorder waiver, which is that's how we pay for a lot of people to get better. These are all very important. But we've got to restore the money to these waiver programs, and we have to hold the department accountable. They need to ask, they need to increase the reimbursement rates for Medicaid so the providers are able to hire people and bring people in to take care of the loved ones and families in West Virginia who need our help. That's the very least that government can do. I think there's a philosophy, maybe a difference in philosophy of the role of government. At the very least, we got to be able to take care of those who cannot take care of themselves. It's not political. We got to fix this.
All right. Delegate and State Democratic Party Chair Mike Pushkin, always appreciate you being on the show, man. Hey,
thanks
a lot.
Thanks for having me on.
All right, coming up on the show tomorrow, Millie Snyder from the Shape Shop is going to be stopping by. Got some other things we're going to get into tomorrow as well. Hoppy and the news. And look who's hanging out in the studio. It's former mayor of Charleston, Danny Jones. He's coming on with Hoppy coming up at 10:06. I will see you tomorrow. Till then, have fun and love somebody.
CHSAM, W243DRFM Charleston, and W283AQ Crosslanes, a WVRC media station. We're proud to live here too.